Hey guys, out for a quick hunt today. The tide's right, the weather's right, so a little overcast, foggy, nobody's around. I'm going to check out this little beach here. A lot of history, I'm not going to show too much. That wharf was actually a grist mill, it was a grist mill actually. Back in the 1800s, it was disbanded in the early 1900s. On the other side of that, there's actually a boat dock where the Loyalists had first come to this town. So I'm poking around in here, and there's not a whole lot of beach to do. I just came from over this way, and there's all kinds of this stuff. Old pottery. It's everywhere. Anyway, I'll show you what I found so far. Pretty much just crapulence. It's all brass tap. I have no idea what this thing's for. It's heavy, sealed. Has a nut on the end of it. And another piece of copper or brass. There's tons of it in here. I'm just trying to sort out the signals and try to find maybe some buttons. I got a nice 1620 spectacle buckle from here. Anyway, I'm going to keep at her and I'll let you know if I find anything else. Bye-bye. Hey guys. Starting to rain, but oh well. Anyway, I've got a find in here. I have no idea what it is, but it looks really, really old. Trying to get a good shot of it. I'll put it on this rock here and see if we can get a good shot. Anybody have any ideas? Looks like it's maybe hollow at the end, but it's got a snap or something on it. I'll clean it up when I get home. When I saw that in the hole, I just about had a stroke. It looked pretty gold to me, but it's not. However, if you look close right there, you can see copper shining through. More of the pink spots there. I think that's plated. And it's decorated. Cool. Alright, I'm going to keep on. See if I can find anything else. See you in a bit. Hey guys. Let me get my camera situated here. Alright. I dug down deep for this. I have no idea what it is. There's a lot of lead that comes out of here, but I don't think it's lead. I actually think it's pewter, so I'm just going to give it a wash. Because to me, it looks like it's decorated. Like it's ornate. And everything here is super, super old. If you find it, it's old. Wow. I haven't got a clue. But man, is that nice. That's pewter. I'm gonna get it home and clean it up. Wouldn't that be wicked if that was like a side plate to something? A musket or something. I don't think so though. Maybe the experts will know. Thanks for looking. Hey guys, next hole, next find. Got ourselves a nice little suspender buckle. Victorian, I'd say. 1890s maybe. Cool. See you at the next one. Hey guys, next find. That is an old coin. Thought somebody was throwing rocks at me. There's apples falling off the apple tree. Not gonna get anything off of it. You kind of see a profile of Britannia, and then down there you can see the line that goes across. More than likely George II. Maybe half penny. Too bad I can't get anything off it. Oh well. On to the next. Hey guys, I found a few things since I last recorded anything, but it was mostly junk. I found two other pennies, probably half pennies, and they're so worn thin that you can't get anything off them whatsoever. Just an example, just let me dig this out of my pouch right quick. Alright, that's one of them. That I just dropped on the ground here. Can't get anything off of that. And this I thought was a small copper coin, farthing or something, until I flipped it over. And it's actually a flat button. Shank is still on it, but man, is that ever worn down. Thin. Cool. See you at the next one. Hey guys, back at her. It was literally only seconds since I dug that last flat button. And I got a little four-hole button. Yeah, it doesn't want to focus. It's so tiny. A little bit of design on the back. Cool. Not sure how old it is, but I'll take it. Hey guys, I literally turned my camera off, picked up the detector, swung once, and I got a coin. All the coppers have been coming out of here. Shiny copper. This is not. I think this is silver. So, let's try to find some water. That's definitely silver. I haven't got a blessed clue, guys. I'm gonna have to try to clean this up a bit more. Oh, that's a bullhead. See if I can get, you'll be able to see his profile. George 3. Oh, come on. You know, any other time, that would zoom right in. Can you see his profile there? That. Oh yeah. Without a doubt. That's a bullhead. Sixpence. Where'd it go? Sweet guys, I'm going to clean that up when I get home. Obviously I'm not going to damage it anymore because look how thin it is. A little baking soda rub and I bet you any money that'll come out nice. At least be able to read it right on. This is a little great spot. There, I'll show you. Hole one, right there. Hole two, right there. Hole three is right here. Hole four, right there. And hole five, where I got the silver. Sweet. So, I'm gonna poke around here and I'll see you again in a minute. Hey guys, this is a wrap up from my 2-hour hunt at the Loyalist Shore that I had yesterday. I'll go through a few things. I got a couple oddballs in here. First is this, I don't know, I think it's a doorknob. But I really don't know. Any guesses? It's going in the scrap pile. Next is this. This is not, it's not metal. This was an eyeball find. And it's got some marks on it. There we go. I don't know if it's like a sharpening stone, or whether it was some type of a graphite pencil thing. I don't know. It's definitely worked anyway. Got the silver fork.
It's not very old. Maybe 100 years or so. Turn of the century. I got this. I thought it was a fuse at first, but it's not. It's the top of a bottle that's been snapped off. That's a cap. So it's probably a perfume bottle, maybe. Again, maybe turn of the century. Because there are some houses above there, above the beach. And they used to toss their garbage pretty much anywhere they could, over a hill mostly. So the only hill is down onto that shore. On the way to the shore, in the path, I got a flat button. Silver plated. Yeah, a Watsit. I'm pretty sure that's just like a sink fitting or something like that. Barrel tap, maybe? Nah, it's definitely probably a sink fitting or an outside water tap. It's got a little bit of age to it, though. We don't make them anymore like that. Yeah, piece of pewter. Looks like an ear. But it does have some design on it. Copper. Big copper spike. They used to build ships there back in the late 1700s. The Loyalists had landed there in 1783. And it was a pretty big shipbuilding port for a bit. And I think that's brass or bronze. Another spike. I'm not going to film them all, just those two, but I found probably a dozen of them. I believe this is a lipstick case. Lipstick holder. I think. It's got a hole on each side. I don't know, maybe. And this cool little buckle thing. I don't know what those letters are. ANN, maybe. Anyway, we've got just a chunk of copper. And again, I have got a stupid amount of this stuff. It's really heavy though. And this stuff is everywhere. I suppose if you take your copper in to have it returned, then you'd probably make a fortune off of that stuff. Got a nice little Victorian. See if it'll focus here. Victorian suspender buckle. Beautiful color on that. Looks gold. It's not, obviously. But the salt water definitely makes them a beautiful color. Got a little tiny, I don't know if it's an underwear button, four-hole button. Nothing written on it. Little buck and ball shot, maybe. It's pretty small. Across the river, there used to be a blockhouse up there, and so I'm sure they used to fire cannonballs and everything. I haven't found a cannonball yet, but I'm sure they probably fired some cannonballs and stuff like that from across the river onto the shore. And I've got three musket balls, different sizes. That one there, I think, is a pistol ball. You can see where it was snipped off. Dropped, not fired. This guy was. It's a little oblong, but it is a musket ball. And this big boy here. Now, onto the cooler things. This, I have no idea what it is, but it's pewter. Very well decorated. I don't know if it's like a leg off of a pot. Or, I don't know, I have no idea. That's what the backside looks like. It's one of my favorite pieces, actually. It's definitely got some age to it. Now, keep in mind, I've also found a 1620 to 1650 spectacle buckle in that same shore. So I'm just waiting for some 1600 stuff. Got a little coin here. It's holed. Can't get anything off it. It's pretty roached. There is a little bit of a bust, but you can't see it on this. And the bust is facing right, I think. And another roached one. Saltwater kills coins. No, yeah, I thought this was a coin. Flip it. It's a button. Colonial. Flat button. No shank. This is the second one of these I found at that site. They come out all shiny like that, but unfortunately they come out extremely worn. It says genuine British copper, and when you flip it over, it's got George III right down there by my thumb. Is 1812 half penny token. The other one's in better shape than this one. Then this come out, and I thought for sure I had hammered 1600s or some type of a 1600s coin here. You can see some lettering there around the inside circle. So that's what I thought. I thought, oh man, there's going to be like a king or something in the center of that. And I have a 1600s coin. I was pumped. Nope. It's actually a flat button. What's left of it? Check out how thin this is. Crazy. Then, the surprise for me for the day. I mean, completely roached. Could barely get anything off of this thing. Oh, it's upside down. Yeah, there we go. Might make it a little easier to see. I'm sorry, my camera keeps freezing. That is mackerel, maybe? Come on. 1816, George III, bullhead, sixpence. It's no wonder it can't get anything off that side. Look how thin that is. That's insane. But it's my first silver out of there. I knew there had to be some silver. But anyway. It's kind of funny because I pounded that site like crazy last year and the year before. I didn't get anything. Well, I did. I got a whole bunch of stuff. But I kept hunting it till I didn't get anything. This year, it's a whole new site. I mean, I've got that stuff. Plus, I've got, at least... Oh, probably got 5 pounds of lead, maybe a little bit more out of there just on this hunt. So, for all those people that take their lead in, and because it's all low alpha lead, if you guys find any low alpha lead, old lead, that stuff is worth quite a bit of money. I just don't have the patience to drag it all up off the beach. I find it, I put it in one spot, I put a rock over it up on the above the high tide mark, and some day I feel ambitious, I might take a run back and pick it all up and find somewhere to take it in and get it recycled. Anyways, folks, that's it for me. Sorry, I haven't been putting out very many videos, but life has been hectic. So we'll try again, probably another couple of weeks. I'll get out, and right now I'm looking at a couple colonial fields. So hopefully I'll have some good stuff to show you. So keep on keeping on, and happy hunting.